Alright, hello guys, in this video we're going to be talking a little bit more about that cooldown that I was calling for, that pattern switch that I was calling for after the 4th of October. We're going to be getting a little bit more in-depth with this one right now because we're getting a little bit closer, obviously. But before I get started with this video, though, I would ask that you do subscribe if you do like weather-related content, and also make sure to check out the links in the description for our social medias, especially Instagram. I'm going to be leaving that in the description. Again, we're doing the photo competitions for each week and month, so that's super cool stuff going on there. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because obviously people are super desperate for a cooldown, so it's like the most popular topic right now, and it does look like we have that cooldown in sight finally for many, but not all. So I'm going to get a little bit more into that because not everybody in the eastern United States is going to be feeling this necessarily, but some and a lot of people will. Now, I wanted to show Noah first off because a lot of people question my credibility a lot of the time, so it's really good when Noah really agrees with what I'm saying, so I can just show this. You know, I'm not the only one seeing this. Here's the 6 to 10 day outlook, and again, the northern United States, I showed this basically in my October forecast, if you checked that out, that the northern, I guess, third of the United States is basically looking to be below average for a prolonged amount of time here. This is from this came out on the 27th, sorry. And then this is from October 3rd through 7th, which is like a really big period in our upcoming cooldown. Because remember, I said the 4th, I think, through the 6th is like one of the big ones. And then around the 8th and 9th looks pretty good too. So this is right in the middle of it. And you can see we have cold for the west, but really the north, central, northeast, Great Lakes, we're all looking below average, especially New England. A model run actually showed snow for New Hampshire and Maine, which is really interesting. I forget which model it was, either the Canadian or the GFS. I don't think we're going to need to watch that. I think it's going to go away, but I think it was interesting to see it showing that this early, only 100 hours out, so very interesting. Now we're going to move on to our 8 to 14 day outlook from NOAA, and you can see things shift a bit more east. Still, the northern third of the United States is below average again, but a lot of the mid-Atlantic and the eastern United States, it dips a lot further south, but you can see the trend is New England is still below average, the Great Lakes are still below average, North Central still below average, and then a lot of the Northwest is still below average as well. So we're seeing this as a common trend throughout the month. I mean, by this point, we're already to the 10th after the 8 to 14 day outlook, so this is the 5th through the 11th. So we're already a third of the way through the month, and this looks to be the pattern that sets in. So this is why we have such a good idea of what the temperature pattern is going to be, because if it's average after this point in the northern United States, or averages out, then we're going to be seeing below average temperatures for the entire month because we saw below average temperatures for that first third. So that's how things kind of work. So as long as we don't see far above average temperatures, we're pretty much golden for this forecast to verify. So here's our 3 to 4 week outlook from NOAA, and this again came out on the 27th, which was 2 days ago, so October 12th through the 25th of 2019, and you can see that top third of the United States still stays equal chances or average. It's the southeast and mid-Atlantic that does have a threat to end up being above average. This is the 12th through the 25th, so this is a big, big chunk of the month basically being taken up in this outlook, so at least the northwestern United States looks to be below average, definitely, for the monthly outlook, because if they're from the 1st through, or the 3rd through the 25th below average, you're almost guaranteed to be below average. You would have to be like 120 degrees Fahrenheit to end up being above average after seeing that many days below average temperatures. You'd have to be that hot for the last 5 days to even make it go back to above average. So it's almost certain that we will see below average temperatures for the Northwest, unless this forecast busts, but I don't think it will. I agree with it for the most part. But we can see the North Central, the Great Lakes, New England, we're equal chances are average. So again, if you average out or end up just being slightly above average or slightly below average, we're good for seeing below average temperatures on the overall grand scheme of things. Now, throughout all three of these, you might have noticed that the Deep South stays warm. And that's the truth. That's what it's looking like right now. And you saw in my October forecast that that's what I'm calling for, that southeast ridge, the southeast, to kind of stay above average temperatures throughout the month of October. This doesn't mean anything for winter. This doesn't mean anything for November. Just October. Right now, short range, things look warm for the Deep South. And I know a lot of people were like, well, look, you were calling for below average temperatures in the fall forecast. At the end of the day, if my seasonal forecast isn't looking to perfectly verify for a certain area, I'm not going to call in a monthly forecast for, I'm not going to lean towards my seasonal forecast. I'm going to lean towards what I think is going to happen. Because at the end of the day, the monthly forecasts are more accurate than the seasonal forecast. The weekly forecasts are more accurate than the monthly forecast. So I'm always going to stick with just trying to be as accurate as I can day to day. That's just how I roll. Now, we're going to be looking at the GEFS, which is the GFS Ensemble model, and we're going to be going almost day by day. I do skip a few days just to, if it looks the same as the day before. You know, I skip a day to save you guys some time. But right now, we're looking at right now. This is Sunday the 29th of September, and you can see we have below average temperatures there for the Northwest, and then warm temperatures for the Southeast, South Central, and Northeastern United States. We are going to move on to the 30th, and you can see we do get that kind of pattern we've been dealing with for so long now. Very warm temperatures there for the Great Lakes and North Central United States. But again, the switch happens on October 4th, so this doesn't mean anything. And this is still in September, so obviously this doesn't mean anything for my October forecast. But October 2nd, you can see we do still have those very warm temperatures there for the North Central, Northeast, Southeast, South Central regions of the United States. It's the Western United States that has the below average temperatures on the 2nd. But by the 4th, we see that switchover, guys. We see that switchover to the Northwest, North Central, Northeast, all of these regions. Again, the top third of the United States seeing below average temperatures. So on the 4th, we do see that switch. And a lot of that central United States, Kansas, Missouri, some of those more southern states are starting to get the colder temperatures as well at times. Now, here's for the 5th. And again, this is where the Mid-Atlantic and some of the southeastern states, just not the very deep south, but some of the southeast states are going to be feeling below average temperatures finally. So this is going to be a little bit of a relief. And just because those outlooks like 6 to 10, 8 to 14, 3 to 4 week outlooks didn't show for the entire time frame seeing below average temperatures for the southeast, that doesn't mean that you won't see a few days in there where you do see some cooler temperatures. We're just going to have to wait and see what happens, because obviously it could be warmer than average the whole time, but that does not mean you won't be seeing below average temperatures at times, because it's so many days. If it's a 7-day forecast and you're looking at above average temperatures, that you could have 2 days below average and then the rest be above average. That's how that would work. But we do see a lot of the Northeast, Great Lakes, and Mid-Atlantic and some Southeast states get below average temperatures here on the 5th. As well, along the East Coast on the 6th, same story, but see top third looking pretty cool, almost the top half at this point. This is a cooler day on the 6th here, Sunday the 6th. And then we can see for the Southeastern United States, Southwestern United States, we do have above average temperatures. Now, on the 7th, it's kind of the same story. This is an ensemble model, so sometimes it gets a little bit less confident and goes with some of those lighter colors, and that's what I think is happening here. But we do have the Northwestern United States, North Central, and Northeastern states below average in temperatures by the 7th. And then by the 9th, you can see it's starting to warm up there in the Eastern United States. The North Central kind of has some warmer temperatures going on, but very, very slight again. So that's not going to really affect the averages, because we've already seen such below average temperatures at times. But the Northeastern and Mid-Atlantic states still dealing with a little bit of below average temperatures. And again, the Northwest is the most confident, as we still see below average temperatures by this point, this Wednesday the 9th. And then Thursday the 10th kind of looks the same as the 9th, Northwest and Northeast. Below average, but North Central is above average. And then by the 13th, Sunday the 13th, we have below average temperatures entering the central states again, the North Central states. And we're warming up a little bit. We're more average in the Northeast, but in the Southeast, we're starting to see a bigger warm up by this point. And then by the 14th, we see a cool down for the central and Northeastern states. So you can see how it's kind of a flip-floppy pattern, but you can tell overall that northern third looks to be below average, at least through the 15th or as far as this model run goes. So we're going to look at it in 5-day increments from this model once again, just to make it easier for you guys to follow. So this is day one. So this is from the 29th of September till the 4th of October. You can see below average temperatures there for the Western United States, and then for the Eastern United States, with the exception of Maine, we're looking at above average temperatures. But from the 4th till the ninth, you can see that top third really looks below average, especially the northwest and northeastern United States, but that north central United States region is still seeing slightly below average temperatures by this point as well. And for our last frame, you can see the 9th through the 14th of October, we kind of go back to the northwestern United States seeing most of the cold, but you can see the north central, a lot of those regions, it's just the Great Lakes have a little bit of above average temperatures. Those lakes are pretty warm, so they're probably getting influenced by that a little bit, but it's so slight that it's not going to affect the average on the grand scheme of things. But New England ends up, and the northeastern United States ends up, being around average for that time frame. Anyway, guys, I hope this video was very helpful on kind of giving you guys an idea of what to expect in the upcoming pattern. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I hope to see you guys in the next one. Thank you so much for watching, and see you guys later.